showing you how this thing is revealed. So you can't be hard-headed, narrow-minded, stuck up. I done seen too many church folk talk like, well, God knows my heart. Man, if you ever want to turn me off, tell me God knows your heart. The minute you ever tell me God knows your heart, that means you're in control of God. Let the Lord walk between you and I while we ask it one from another. All God knows is his word. Yes. And your response is word. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes. So let me just move on. You see the pattern here?
Yes.
That there's an instruction with a promise, and the promise cannot kick in until after the instruction is followed. Well, let's just use Moses. God introduced himself to Moses. Moses grew up in Egyptians. He didn't know God. God showed up in the wilderness. And amongst a burning bush. Moses. Moses looked around and said, who that calling me? He said, I'm the God of Abraham. Your father Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said, come on now, my people are in trouble. I'm going to send you to the living and God.
Come on.
I have some instructions for you.
My Lord.
That don't make sense. I need you to go back to Pharaoh even though you ain't trying to kill you.
Yes, Lord.
Glory to God. You would have never heard about Moses if he didn't follow instruction.
Yes,
God wanted to kick him to the side and get somebody else to bring the people out. I mean, they're preaching about somebody else. God said, I have an instruction for you, son. I have a great work for you to do, Josh. But I have an instruction for you. I need you to go back to Egypt. Y'all remember that he ran away from Egypt because they're trying to kill him? God says, I want you to go back to the people. Oh, God, I feel like preaching. If you didn't hear me say amen, I feel like preaching. He said, I want you to see this is the God we serve. God is not in the popularity and comfort. God is in the glory, baby.
Yes,
I mean, God is going to use you in something great. Glory to God. It's going to come with an instruction.
Okay.
I remember when I sat on my bed, and the Lord said, boy, I published that book. I was being raised up a new boy. Everybody knew me. I was popular in new boy. Everybody come to me for counseling. The Lord said, I got something else for you to do. The right thing I need you to do is publish the book.
Yes, Lord.
My God. My God.
Book got me kicked out.
All right.
But here I am. So he said, oh God, I feel the Holy One. He told Moses, I'm giving you a promise. You're going to deliver Israel, but he has the instruction. You're not going to deliver them through your prayer.
Come on now.
You got to go back in the lines then.
Oh yes.
You got to prove that you believe me.
Come on. Stay right there, Pastor.
See, the only proof that you believe the promise is the action of faith.
Yes, sir.
That's another right there for somebody. The only proof that you believe the promise is when you follow instruction.
Oh, yes.
You can dance all you want to.
Come on now.
Sing on the praise team, preach the gospel, bring the pastor water,
yeah.
Give all your tithe, which is a promise to go with that, but for the promise you're believing for in your personal life,
come on now.
It's going to manifest after you follow instruction. See, sometimes it takes the next instruction to bring you a promotion.
Yeah.
Most people in church get stuck dancing because they don't want to follow instruction. And while the promotion is available to them, they never walk in it because they never follow the instruction.
Come on now.
Oh, ain't nobody saying anything, man. I done lost the whole church right now. Every time God's going to do something great, he's going to give you an instruction. Do I need to change this?
Amen.
Do I need to change it? Amen. One more time, I'm changing it. Get that mic for me, please. What am I saying to you? Can I take with your own personal life?
Yes.
Okay, so the righteous of faith started with Noah. God gave him an instruction. God introduced himself to Noah through an instruction and a promise. He introduced himself to